Hello students, today we are going to see a procedure of admission bail. So before I start with the procedure, I would like to give an overview of the procedure. In this procedure, we are going to see the definition of bail making, the purposes of bail making, types of bail making, principles of bail making, preliminary assessment for the bail making, the complete procedure of the bail making, after care of articles, recording and reporting. So before I start with the procedure, I would like to tell you the definition of bed making. Bed making is a systematic way of performing or preparation of a bed for the patient to receive the patient for the admission. Bed making is a process where we prepare a clean, neat, tidy and wrinkle-free bed for the patient so that the patient will be free from the bed sore. Then the purposes of bed making is performed usually to provide a clean and comfortable bed to the patient. Bed making is also prepared to give a safe and comfortable environment to the patient. It is also prepared to for the patient to promote a rest and sleep. By doing the bed making, we also develop an effective interpersonal relationship with the patient. We also observe the patient for the hygienic care. Then we give a neat and tidy appearance, and then we also keep the patient neat and tidy, and the patient will feel comfortable after performing the after receiving a clean bed. Now the types of bed making, there are basically two types of bed making: simple bed and special bed. In the simple bed, there are two types, that is open bed or occupied bed, closed bed or unoccupied bed. In the special beds, the beds are divided as amputation bed, renal bed, cardiac bed, burn bed, etc. Now coming to the principles of bed making, there are four principles of bed making. First is principle of anatomy and physiology. Second is principle of physics and chemistry. Third one is principles of microbiology. And fourth one is principles of psychology. So coming to the first principle, that is principles of anatomy and physiology. Usually when we see the body structure, our body is made up of a hard and soft tissues which lie against the mattresses. So when the patient is lying on the bed for continuous or prolonged period of time, the hard as well as soft surfaces or tissues comes in the contact with the mattress. The hard tissues are as follows, like we have a spine, then the shoulder joints, shoulder blades, hip, knees and the heels. Okay, so these are the hard pressure points which continuously come in contact with the patient's mattress, at the mattress. And the soft tissues are the buttocks. So what happens when the patient is lying on the bed for prolonged period of time, the patient may have a risk for getting a bed sore. So to prevent that, we are performing a bed making. Second is principles of physics and chemistry. Now we have to make sure that the lights are on, fans are off, and there is adequate ventilation and adequate sunlight in the room. When we are performing a bed, make sure that the nurse is maintaining a proper body mechanics so that she may prevent a backache. Then she has to maintain an adequate distance between the bed and herself. Make sure that the patient's bed is not touching the uniform of the nurses. Then coming to the principles of microbiology, we have to wash our hands properly with proper disinfectant to prevent auto-infection as well as cross-infection. If the nurse has any kind of cold or cough, she should not attend the patient. Now we have to always prefer a damp or wet dusting, because in the dry dusting, the dust particle raises. So we have to prevent that. Make sure that there is adequate ventilation in the room, and when we are performing the bed making, make sure that the linens are not touching the floor or not touching the uniform or not touching the bed of the other patients. Now when the bed sheets are soiled with any body fluids or any blood content, make sure that it is first disinfected with 10% of hypochlorite solution, and then only it is sent to the laundry bag. Okay. Now coming to the principles of psychology, we have to give psychological support to the patient. We have to talk to the patient, because bed making is also performed to develop an effective interpersonal relationship with the patient. So we have to collect the history of the patient, we have to observe the patient, and we have to give comfortable position to the patient. So these are the four principles applied in the bed making. Now coming to the preliminary assessment, we have usually four P's, that is preparation of the patient, preparation of the nurse, preparation of the environment, and preparation of the article. So preparation of the nurse should be thorough with the procedure, the nurse should be skillful about the procedure, make sure that the nails are cut short, there is no nail paint, the jewelry is from the hands, the rings and the bracelet has to be removed, and then she has to gather all the articles. Now coming to the articles required for the procedure, we require two sheets. One is a bottom sheet, then we require a draw sheet with a Macintosh to protect the bed from linen, then we require a top sheet to cover the patient, and we require one blanket in case depending on the climate, and we require a pillow cover to cover the pillow and the pillow. So these all articles are required for admission bed. Now coming to the preparation of the environment, make sure that the light is on, fan is off, and if necessary we have to provide screen to provide a privacy to the patient. So these are the preparation of the patient, preparation of the nurse, preparation of the articles, and preparation of the environment. So now I'm going to start with my procedure. Before I start with my procedure, I have to go for hand washing. After the hand washing, we have to prepare a bed, admission bed for the patient. So first, I will be taking a bottom sheet. Without touching the patient's bed, I have to put a bottom sheet. Just unfold the bed sheet. Now we have to secure the bed sheet from one side. So lift the bed sheet, lift the mattress up and secure the bed sheet. Come to the foot end of the patient. Tightly pull the bed sheet, lift the mattress up and tuck the foot end. Now I have to prepare a little corner. From both the sides. I will show you how to prepare a mitted corner when I will come to the opposite side. Now I have to place a draw sheet and Macintosh approximately 35 cm from the head end. Macintosh is usually placed to prevent or to protect the bed sheets from spoiling. Now, tuck the bed sheet, head end, middle end, foot end. Now, one side of the bed sheet is already tucked properly, so I will be going to the opposite side. Stand at the opposite side at the head end of the patient, pull the bed sheet properly. And this is how we prepare a mitted corner. Pull the bed sheet properly. Now unroll the draw sheet and Macintosh. Come to the foot end of the patient and tightly pull the bed sheet, lift the mattress and prepare a mitted corner. Now again go to the head end, tuck the bed sheet, and we have to maintain a body mechanics and we have to bend in our knees to prevent the. Now the opposite side of the bed sheet is also secured. Now I have to go to the right side of the patient. Take the top sheet. Without touching the patient's bed, I have to spread the top sheet. Unfold the top sheet. Make sure that you will not overreach the bed of the patient. Now, we have to take a blanket and spread it over the top sheet. Unfold the blanket. Now always remember that the not be come in contact with the patient, so we have to cover it with a top sheet. That is the reason I have first spread the top sheet. Now after spreading the blanket, I have to turn to the opposite side. Cover the upper part of the blanket. Now, after that, I have to secure the top sheet and the blanket. So, tightly pull the blanket and the top sheet. Similar way, make a knitted corner. And tuck the opposite side. Now I will be going to the right side of the patient. Now after this, I have to take a pillow cover. Without touching the patient's bed or your uniform, put the pillow inside the pillow cover. Pull it away from your face, and the open end of the pillow should be closed properly, and it has to be always kept opposite to the entrance. Now place the pillow cover. This is how we have to prepare a wrinkle-free admission bed for the patient. Now when we are preparing an admission bed for the patient, we also have to keep few extra articles like IV stand. We have to provide a locker to the patient. We have to provide a patient with a clean uniform, a glass of water, jug and a spoon. Also we have to keep a call bell near the patient. Whenever the patient wants to call us, he may press the call bell and he can call us. After preparing an admission bed for the patient, we have to replace the articles. So before replacing the article, we have to make sure that whatever articles we have removed previously, if we have to send it for the laundry, if the previous linens are spoiled with a body fluids or a blood, we have to first disinfect with hypochlorite solution. And then we have to send it for the laundry. Now few articles like mattresses and pillows cannot be washed. So we have to disinfect these articles under the sunlight. Now a very important thing is when we use a Macintosh and a Macintosh is spoiled by any blood or body fluids, we have to wash it under the running soap and water. After that we have to dry it in the shadow. After drying we have to powder it and roll it and replace it in the cupboard. So after the replacing the articles, we have to wash our hands thoroughly and we have to do recording and reporting. In the recording and reporting, we have to record that admission bed is prepared for bed number 1. All the essential articles are kept near the patient. Uniform is provided for the patient. Thank you.